Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to the channel. For the last couple of weeks, I've been working with a WebGL toolkit and plugin for Maya called Verge 3D that allows you to create interactive portfolios, showcases for products and designs, physics simulations, and even games on the web. The developers sent me a license and asked me to review the software, so in order to know whether or not I could recommend it, I gave myself a project to test it out with a production-like end goal in mind. I created a chronograph watch with functional buttons and some different styles for a mock e-commerce site. We'll take a more in-depth look at this later on in the video. One note before we begin, Verge 3D is also available for Blender and 3ds Max. My experience is based solely on the Maya version, but the functionality of the Blender and Max plugins appears to be the same, as is the interface for creating the web app. Alright, so if that sounds good, let's jump right into the overview. So viewing 3D models and creating graphics in a web browser is not a new concept. WebGL is a JavaScript API for real-time graphics rendering directly in the browser, and there's a wide variety of WebGL frameworks, such as 3JS, Babylon.js, and services like Clara.io, Sketchfab, and Marmoset Viewer, which you've probably seen before. Verge 3D is also built on the same framework. So how do you actually get your 3D art online in an interactive form? Well, without using a service, there's arguably a lot of manual work required. This is where Verge 3D comes in, as it bridges the gap between Maya and WebGL without relying on coding experience or a cloud-based service. Both are important features, but I wanted to touch on the latter point before we move on to looking at the software itself. Verge 3D is cloud independent. It runs completely offline. While you can choose to publish your app on Verge 3D's servers if you don't have a website up and running, it is designed to be self-hosted. This means that you're not locked into using Verge 3D's network like you are with Sketchfab, for example. You simply deploy your app to your own website and you control it. If the company shuts down or development of Verge 3D stops, nothing changes to your work. And this is a very important aspect to consider. Now, of course, you could choose one of the aforementioned frameworks for free, but you will need to do coding for yourself, which is another selling point for Verge 3D. So for artists, the visual programming in Verge 3D is pretty straightforward. It's based on Google Blockly, and you can create fairly complex puzzles, as they're called here, by using the provided library. Now, if you do have programming experience, you're not required to use the puzzles, and you can program your app directly with JavaScript using Verge 3D's API, or you can use a combination of the two. I did most of the programming with the puzzles, but I also wrote some super simple functions for measuring the elapsed time when clicking the chronograph pushers, and to create a modulo function, which is sadly missing as one of the puzzle block operators. If anything, Verge 3D almost simplifies the programming too much, but it's all in an attempt to make starting out less intimidating. But like I said, you can use the puzzles as much or as little as you like. For any user's experience with the 3JS framework, the Verge 3D API is very similar, and much of the 3JS source code is compatible. There's a ton of examples ported from 3JS to Verge 3D, and it's documented on their site. I referenced this to add tone mapping to my watch app to prevent the specular highlights from clipping. All right, so let's take a look at my project. When I first heard about the software, I thought that an e-commerce site would be the perfect use case. There's a popular, affordable watch company called Movement, and they have so many different styles of the same overall designs. Wouldn't it be cool if you could just select one of the designs that you liked, pick a style or a color scheme, and then view it in 3D instead of only getting a few stills? So I have kind of a thing for watches, so the basic idea was to create a proof of concept for a watch site. So you can check the site out for yourself. There are two links in the description. One is self-hosted on my site, and the other is hosted on the Verge 3D network, and that one might load just a little bit faster. Now, this site is far from complete, and most of the icons and UI are just mock placeholders. I'm also not a web designer, and I felt a little bit out of my league creating this, but you've got presets on the left or underneath if you're on a smaller screen, and a little description. The most fun part for me though was making the watch features functional. Right away, you should see that the time is your local system time, and so is the date. If you hover over the body, annotations appear. There are several different styles of chronograph watches, so for this, the seconds is not the larger second hand, it's in the subdial. The big second hand is for measuring the elapsed seconds, because it's easier to read. Then we've got a tenth of a second dial, which measures the elapsed time to the nearest tenth of a second, and then a 30-minute dial. So to try this out, press the top pusher and the chronograph starts. To stop it, you click it again, and you'll notice that the tenth of a second hand moves. All right, so let's start this again and then press the split time pusher. So now the chronograph hands stop to allow you to read the elapsed time. The time is measured in the background, so when you press it again, the hands move up to display the elapsed time since you activated the split time, and then it continues until you stop. To reset the chronograph, click the bottom pusher again, and the hands reset. You can also pull out the crown, which stops the watch, and when you reset the crown, the watch starts again, but now the time is out of sync since we obviously removed power to the watch. If the chronograph hands are ticking, pulling the crown automatically resets the chronograph hands too. So this is probably overkill, but I wanted to test out the software with something a bit more complex than a simple model to orbit around. We could also take this one step further and allow the user to customize specific components of the watch, like changing the body color or the back plate or the strap. That was my original intention, I just ran out of steam for the last part. Don't underestimate how long web design takes, which we'll talk about in a moment. Anyway, this is what I believe will be the future of e-commerce sites. Although it does come with a caveat for vendors because now they're gonna need to provide their customers with accurate models, which from my experience is not really the case, that often the client will provide you with a model that doesn't exactly match the reference images that they sent you, but that's a discussion for another time. Okay, so let's take a look at Maya and how you export the scene to Verge 3D. So overall, you work in Maya as you would normally, but there are a few things to keep in mind. First of all, make sure you name the transform nodes, otherwise you will have no clue what to reference later on. And then delete the history to remove unnecessary nodes. The animation can be done either programmatically in Verge 3D, such as what I did for the watch hands, or you can animate in Maya and export keyframes, such as the button presses. For animating objects though, you'll probably need to bake the pivot points so they work properly in Verge 3D. This option is under Modify Bake Pivot. For materials, you can use the standard Maya materials such as Blinds, Lambert's Fongs, and the Maya Standard Surface, or the separate Arnold Standard Surface. Verge 3D supports most of the material channels, so you can simply make the material as you would normally, and the texture nodes export correctly. It is worth checking the documentation for a complete compatibility list, as some things aren't supported. Many of the Arnold utility nodes don't work, and unfortunately anisotropic reflections are not yet supported as of this review. So I did ask about this on the forums, and the developers say that it is planned. So here I have quite a lot of materials. It would have been much better to simply have one material per material type, and then just switch out the textures programmatically when the user selects one of the other watch designs. I didn't do that for this project, but it would definitely improve performance. For lighting, you can use standard lights, but it's more efficient just to use image-based lighting with an HDR. For this, you just use the Arnold Skydome light. To export, there are a few settings you might want to change, such as the animation keyframe range and whether or not you want to use compression, and then you just export the scene. Then load up the app. So Verge 3D's renderer will produce different results to Arnold. Don't expect a one-to-one result. Keep in mind that this is a real-time renderer built for the web browser, so set your expectations accordingly. So for this app, in the puzzles section, there's quite a lot of variables and logic for the watch features, and then an entire section for watch materials. I realized after I'd done all this that a more efficient approach would be to limit the number of materials like I mentioned before and then just switch the textures, but I ran out of steam at the end. But there's always things that you can improve, and there's certainly things I could improve with this project. Now let's talk about the web design and development aspect of this. In most reasonable scenarios, the artist is probably not going to be responsible for creating the 3D assets, setting up the programming in Verge 3D, and also developing the website. Those are all very different tasks, but then again, I know what some clients are like. But if you do want to make a little proof of concept like this or an interactive portfolio, this next part is important. In order to get the most out of Verge 3D, you'll want to create a web page with a UI to interact with the scene. For this, I used Webflow. Unfortunately, this is an added cost, as the functionality we need is only available for paid plans. You're not required to use a web builder, but I, for one, am not a great web designer, and I haven't built a website from scratch in years. So even though that I'm not too fond of this design, especially with these old school type icons, it gets the job done for a proof of concept. So using a web builder helped me to produce this faster than it would have by doing the site manually. At first I was determined to use a free solution and I tried to use Google Web Designer. And while you can get it to work, it's cumbersome in the way that it works with saving to existing directories, to the point where it was just more hassle than it was worth. So unless you want to do this from scratch, you will need a web builder that allows you to embed custom HTML and then export the entire site as HTML, CSS, and JavaScript files to deploy elsewhere. So Webflow has these features and is recommended by the developers too. Now, another note is that you can't deploy the site back on Webflow after creating the Verge 3D app, because Webflow doesn't actually allow you to host your own JavaScript files on their platform. So I recommend it just for building the UI. And if you are new to web design and development, or you need a refresher, Webflow does have a large collection of good tutorials on YouTube, so I also recommend Webflow. But after you create the UI, you export it to the Verge 3D app folder, and then you can make the buttons functional. For example, when the user clicks the various watch presets, the materials change in the watch, and that is based on the ID of the icon that you created in Webflow. Then when you're all finished, you can upload the app to Verge 3D servers or deploy it to your own site. So for this, I created a subdomain for my own site and transferred the entire app folder to it via FTP. For a comprehensive tutorial series covering just about everything that you need to get started with your own app, check out the developers' tutorials. I've also linked to those in the description. Their documentation is pretty good too, and if you do need help, a lot of users and developers are active on the forums. Lastly, let's talk about pricing. Now, this is sometimes a touchy subject, but I'd say the cost is reasonable. For freelancers, it costs just under $300 US, and it's a one-time purchase, not a subscription. Now, you do have to pick Maya, Blender, or Max to get the right plugin, and I do believe you have to pick the one up front, that you can't buy the Maya plugin and then decide to use it with Blender. I think you have to pick the version that you want to stick with. Definitely grab a trial though and play around with it. So check the link in the description again for that. The only limitation with a trial is that there's a watermark, but otherwise it's fully functional and doesn't expire. So if it isn't clear by now, I do recommend Verge 3D. I spent a couple of weeks experimenting with it and working on this whole project, and I think I barely scratched the surface of what you can create with Verge 3D and WebGL in general. But if you have any questions, leave a comment or reach out on the Discord server. If you enjoyed the video and you think my overview of Verge 3D was insightful, a like really helps out the channel. Otherwise, I'll see you guys next time. Peace.